Be quiet. Be thou silent, Tech. Okay. Try to figure this thing out. Can you hear me? Can everybody in the thing hear me? Hang on a second. Hello, hello. Can anybody hear me? Hang on a second. Blah, blah, blah. Trying to get this going. Oh, oh frig, there are people in the chat box. Yo, Marik, what's up? Well, nipples, says Winged Caribho. That's actually my real name. Nip is Winged Caribho. I'm not Little Caribho, I'm Marik. I'm your friendly neighborhood Marik, who occasionally swears vengeance upon the entire neighborhood. OMG, hi! OMG! OMG! OMEG is what you're trying to say. OM Egyptian God. Oh my Egyptian God. OM goodness. OM badness. Holy frig, the chat is going like it's going like the clappers, as my dad used to say. Has anybody heard that phrase? Going like the clappers. Hi, Alan Caddle, I think his name was. Whoa! Pinky M. Feels, that's unfortunate. Lil Caribho, who is that guy? Who knows? Who knows who that is? I'd like to take a moment. Can I play drums? I can play anything. I can play any instrument, provided that instrument is the sound of my beautiful voice. I can simulate the sound of any instrument with my fantastic singing vocals. My vocalistics. For example, here is a triangle. You know the famous musical instrument, the triangle. Ding! That was amazing. Thank you. Thank you, I'm bowing. You can't see me, but I am bowing right now. I wanted to say, everyone's asking about Bacora. Listen. 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 Bacora and I, it's like the Game Grumps situation. Everybody wants Egoraptor and Jontron. Well, you can't have that right now. You can't have Bacora and Marik right now. It's me, and it's me on my lonesome. Sorry about that, if that's a disappointment. Marik, somebody's challenging me to a duel in the chat. How silly. Look at how silly you are, person in the chat. Little tiny words on the screen. You think I'm intimidated by words on a screen? Well, except for all the times that I've been cyberbullied in my life and have gone crying to Bacora, but that doesn't count. Everybody's trying to get me to notice them. I'm not your senpai. I ain't your senpai. I'm not even half a senpai. Not even a pie or a sen. I might be a pie. I like pie. Anyway, I wanted to say, listen, I wanted to say before we get started, let me tweet about the fact that I'm experiencing video games. Here we go. I'm tweeting with @YugiohTAS. Nobody else is joining for this stream, it's just me. And I apologize if a one-man show... I apologize if my primitive one-man video game stream is not enough for you. F the police, says Swagnarok. That is a badass name. Here, I'm tweeting. I, as Marik, am playing games live on my YouTubes. On my tubes is what I wrote. I don't want to play games with my tubes. There we go. I play games with my tubes every night. Okay, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. I wanted to say... Listen. I wanted to say... The pie is not a lie, the pie is truth. I want to say, thank you so much for putting down your copy of Pokemon Go, your physical copy of the digital app game. Thank you so much for putting that game down so that you can play my version of Pokemon Go, which is Pokemon Stay Home and Listen to Marik and Don't Play Pokemon. That's my version of Pokemon Go. It's like Flappy Bird. They had a bunch of rip-offs when they took that game down. My version of the Flappy Bird rip-offs is to not do that. Here we go. Playing from the beginning because... I don't want to ruin the gameplay that we've been playing with Bakura. I don't want to infringe on the deep lore, the canonical storyline of frigging Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines that is happening with Bakura. That is silly. That would confuse everybody. It would be like trying to understand any given storyline in the Marvel Universe right now. It's all convoluted and makes no sense, and they keep restarting everything and confusing everybody. I think that, I think friggin' Johnny Storm has died twice now. Anyway, we're starting a new game. Thank you. I appreciate you saying it is considerate. Team Mystic, more like Team Marik. Answer a series of questions about the type of vampire you would like to play, and allow the game to create your character. I'm a passive guy. I'm not a very aggressive guy. I like the game to tell me what to do. It's like taking a Facebook quiz. We're gonna do that one. Okay, would you like your character to be one male or two female? Well, they're gonna be vampires either way. Team Marik, that's right. Hashtag Team Marik. My version of Pokemon Go would just be, it would be an augmented reality game where you're trying to walk around the city trying to find the Pharaoh, and you could find various millennium items as well, and also the leather pants. Leather pants Go. Imagine, it is the Booty Lord. Thank you, Emerald Stag. You know my official title. Thank you. Male or female, listen, in order to distinguish our characters, the character we're playing in the one, you know, the one I was playing with Bakura before he left. And I'm still bitter about that, by the way. In order to distinguish them, I'm gonna make this one a girl, a smelly girl. Content warning, there are cooties involved, vampire cooties. They're like twice the parasite. As you're walking home, what? This is like taking the friggin' goat in Fallout 3. I don't appreciate that. Starlight says, will you have my babies, Marik? Learn to spell my name correctly, and I might offer you my children. That's all it takes, is some proper spelling acumen. Okay, as you're walking home late at night, somebody spells your name wrong and then asks for your babies. No. You hear footsteps, glance back, and suddenly realize someone is following you. Oh, this happens to me all the time. Usually, it's one of my rare hunters or Odeon, and I'm like, holy frig! And then I realize I told them to follow me. And it's very confusing. Slenderman is not behind me. Slenderman, I wish he was behind me. I wish I could put Slenderman behind me and say, you're in the past, Slenderman. I don't have to deal with you. Whoa, who's Maria? Good Lord. Too eternal to confront them. Or duck behind it. Who the hell do you think I am? Duck behind a tree. The tree will be of no use to you. I confronted the frig out of them. Panda Bear, I did notice you. The pie has noticed you. You're at a nightclub. Hell yes, I am. I am the nightclub. Having a damn good time. Hell yes, I am. I am the damn good time. When you realize you're out of money, are you kidding me? I have never had to spend an actual single unit of money in my entire friggin' life. I am beautiful. People pay for me. I am a celebrity. I go into a nightclub and they're like, would you like to own the nightclub because we've seen how sexy your butt is? No cash, no fun. Are you kidding me? I can make fun without money. I can't believe this game is criticizing my lifestyle. Do you? Yes. Do you seduce somebody and have them pay for your drinks every friggin' day? Did you say Marik, Sebastian, Ishtar? Do you like to breathe oxygen? Yes. I also like to breathe oxygen while seducing people and having them pay for my drinks. I don't drink, but they're still gonna pay for my friggin' drinks. I do notice you, Amber. Hello. Number two, time it just right so you can snatch a bottle while the bartender isn't looking. That's some sneaky stuff. That's some pretty friggin' sneaky stuff. But also illegal. Actually, I have no problem committing a crime. Nobody cares if you're beautiful. They will be like, oh, you did this horrible thing, but you look nice. Eh, I'll let you go. Go home and read a book or listen to music. Who the hell do you think I am? Something else more intellectualistic. Wasting life in a lame club? This is Bakora's answer right here. I don't care for that. I'm seducing the hell out of them. Boobies, says Synchro Banana. That's the kind of interesting discussion you'll get from a Marik Sebastian Ishtar stream. The unalive stream. You were mugged last night. Is this a question or are you just telling me and I forgot about it? It wasn't life-threatening, but you ought to take some measures to make sure if it happens again you aren't defenseless. I am never defenseless. I am always armed with a smart witticism and a seductive smile. My body is my weapon. 7.8 out of 10, too much water. What? Don't be silly. Do you? 1. Sign up for a martial arts class. I have rare hunters to do my martial arts for me. Next time they try it, you'll break their spine. That's a bit of an overreaction, don't you think? I mean, it wasn't even life-threatening. It says right there. But you want me to be spine-threatening. Okay. Okay, it just escalated very quickly is all I'm saying. Bakora, I will not answer you even if you call me love. You know, if you were the real Bakora, you would know that our cute pet name was not love. It is the opposite of love. Boa Hancock gets away with everything too because she is beautiful. Yes, she does. I'm also the romantic love interest of Monkey D. Luffy as well. Nobody knows it. It's coming up in the final part of the One Piece storyline. If they ever get there. 2, start carrying a knife and conceal it in your belt. I have so many friggin' belts. It's a pain to take them off. I just wear them to bed. Next person who tries it breathes through. Holy frig, this is violent. I just told you that if I wanted a drink, I would just seduce somebody. Then you're like, hey, what if somebody got into a bit of a scuffle with you? Oh, I'll just stab them in the neck. Buy a gun. No. I'm not going to own a gun. Nobody in Yu-Gi-Oh! Has guns. And if they do, they are not visible to the naked eye. I'm going to take a knife. It's the closest thing we have to my Millennium Rod. Dragonov says, what game is this again? Well, the stream title says Marik plays Bloodlines. So I'm going to guess that it's Call of Duty. Yeah, probably. You're in a convenience store, looking through the beer freezer. Freezer, that's a familiar word. It reminds me of a different nasally British-sounding villain. When all of the sudden, is that a colloquialism? Is that what people say? When all of a sudden, the man walks in and pulls the gun on a cashier. Oh, so now I'm the vigilante Marik Ishtar. Sneak up behind him, disarm him with my attractive buttocks, and proceed to beat him senseless with my attractive buttocks. Quietly make your way to the bathroom. Actually, no, totally, because that's way more interesting than what could possibly happen if I tried. Why is every answer violence? Do you wonder about that? Do any of you in the chat wonder, you know, why the answer to everything is always violence? Can't we have, like, option A, punch the guy, option B, kill the guy, option B, learn about the guy's past and maybe identify with him on an emotional level and maybe share some psychological trauma that makes you empathize with each other and then makes you friends again? I feel like I just described my relationship with Bakora. Fuck the guy with the gun, Marik? Are you kidding me? He has a frigging gun! Who suggested that? You're outbid at an auction. Ridiculous! For a macabre piece of art. Macabre piece of art. That's macabre. How do you say it? Macabre? I've heard people say macabre and macabre. Macabre. Abracadabra piece of art that you just must have. What it is, it's it's a piece of art that a deviant art artist has I've commissioned, and it's Bakora half naked on a beach with sunburn on his hiney parts, and I must have it. You know the collector who won it. You've even been to his house. It was Yugi. Frig that guy. Do you? Kate Williams says, your voice is sexy that it doesn't matter how it's pronounced. That's right, Kate Williams. I will pronounce everything wrong and it will still be right. Get a few drinks into him later on. Hey, we're back to the seducing thing, okay. And persuade him to sell it to you. It's macabre. Wait until he leaves. Find his spare key. How do we know he has one? Okay. I'm just saying, that's a bit of an assumption on your part, video game. Dialogue text options. And make it look like a robbery. A macabre robbery. Or write an... this is the best. Write an unflattering critique on the artist. Get it published. And just wait for your friend to try and unload it. So basically, spam him with internet hate is the third option. Be an internet troll. I believe that that's the correct answer. It's not violent, and it doesn't... Wait, none of these are violent. Hey, we've progressed as a culture. I'm still going to write the critique. Being a night person, what does that mean? Am I an owl? Am I a macabre owl? I believe so. Marika Bakora sitting in a tree, K-I-S-S-I-N. Hold on, I know what that spells. You watch a lot of late night TV movies. Yes, I do. My favorite is Sexy Egyptian Thief King with a Tan, Part 3, The Roughening. Three movies are on, which one do you watch? Fist of the Monkey King? This is friggin' Dragon Ball Z. A waifu film with that scene where Woo beats 20 armed men with his bare hands. It's Ip Man. That's Ip Man. You just described Ip Man. Swords of the Bushy. I don't know if that was very racist, but if it was, call me on it, please. Japanese film where a lone samurai cuts a path through a gang of Yakuza. I know how to pronounce that. I've played enough Yakuza games. What does Marik think of the WWE draft? Well, they must all be feeling a WWE draft because they don't wear many clothes. So if it's cold in the arena, they must be chilly. That's what I think. Funny jokes. Okay, carrying on. Whoa, 3, Sergeant Murderstein. 3. The cop that doesn't play by the rules takes on the drug cartel that kidnapped his daughter with only his trusty 44 to back him up. I'm going to assume 44 is another name for an Egyptian god card. Why can you only hear Marik out of your left ear? Is that a problem everybody's happening, or is that something... Because I thought I was coming out of both ears. I usually come out of both ears. That's always been my understanding. Lisa Holzhofer says, Marik, my man. Okay. Am I only coming out of the left ear, really? That would be unfortunate. You need the entire 360-degree Marik experience. Only the left ear, frig. Why is that happening? I don't know why that's happening. Let me see if I can adjust things. Hang on. I'm opening. Frig. Try now. Do I sound better now? Some people are saying it's coming out to the left. Some people are saying it's coming out to the right. I should have fixed it, maybe. Let me know if I fixed it. Better. I'm so sorry that you could only get 50% of the Marik experience. That's unfortunate. I feel like I gypped all of you. Sorry about that, guys. That was on me. I'm not very technically minded, because I don't know if you've noticed, I live in the desert. And my most high-tech piece of equipment is Odeon. So, anyway, Sergeant Murderstein 3. That's happening. You're stuck in traffic. Ridiculous. Command them to move, Odeon. Find someone called Steve and have him drive off the road and distract everybody. After a concert, and the guy behind you is laying on the horn. Bakora always lays on the horn. It's annoying. He's so rude. Your friends in the car are urging you to park the car and help them stick dude's horn somewhere uncomfortable. Bakora always sticks dude's horn somewhere uncomfortable. Macabre. You got 100%, says Insanity. Of course you did, you're insane. Do you get out and pull the guy out of the car and put him in the hospital? That's unnecessary. Like, be patient. Be patient. Come on. Take some time. Take a deep breath. I mean, obviously, I'm not a vampire, so I don't know if they have road rage. If that's a side effect of... The side effects of being a vampire are... You can't see yourself in the mirror. You require blood to sustain you. And driving is really annoying. You get very upset when there's a delay. Okay, speak Egyptian. Sorian, come on. Nobody speaks Egyptian anymore, do they? Do they speak Egyptian? I don't know. Talk your friends down. You don't need a lawsuit or jail time. They're right. I don't need a lawsuit or any other kind of suit, because suits cover my sexy abdominals. Wow, this quiz is long. This is the longest and hardest quiz I've ever friggin' taken. Skull Blue Fire 47 Anime says... I never thought that I would hear a name quite as nerdy as Skull Blue Fire 47 Anime, but you've impressed me, sir. Marik, would you like a bike? I have a bike. Technically, I do. I have a motorcycle. It belongs to Odeon, but I get to sit in the sidecar. And I sit there and I'm like, yay, the wind is in my hair and I have none of the responsibility of driving. Free the abdominals! Your new neighbor is everything you've ever wanted in someone. How do you get them to go out with you? Is mind control an option? No. Spend a good amount of time around the windows topless. Yes! Okay, this game knows me now. It's asked all the previous questions to understand my frame of mind, and now they finally understand what I would do, because yes, absolutely, nudity is the answer. Why isn't nudity the answer to like 90%, 100% of all questions, not just in this game? All questions. You're on a hike in the woods. Slenderman's going to get involved now. Here we go. You're on a hike in the woods near dark. What? Oh, near dark? I was going to say, the woods are near the dark. Those are some talented woods. They're just always relocating themselves if it gets too bright. When you spot a mountain lion on the path ahead of you. Frig, man. If this was Skyrim, I would take it out. But I don't know. Do you grab a branch and run after it? That's what I do with anything that approaches me. Somebody just asks me for help with something. They ask for the time. I grab a branch and run after them screaming. Try it sometime. Combine it with nudity. Since nudity is the answer for everything. Grab a branch, run after it screaming naked. Or gather up a handful of rocks and start throwing them. Why is there no option? Why is there no peaceful option? Why is it always rage? Why is there always nude rage involved? Grabbing a branch. Jesus, this is a freaking long quiz. Can you believe this? I don't believe this. Connor Burke says, does Pecora mind you're not a villain anymore? Is that canon? Is that canonical? Oh, because yes, in the show, in Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged, I'm not a villain. But I don't know if you've heard this before. I don't know if anybody's told you. Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged is a work of fiction. So, what's happening right now, this is totally real. This is totes real. I'm still a villain. I'm still illin. I'm still chillin. I'm still violinin. I occasionally play the violin in an evil way. Listen, I told you earlier, my vocals skills and technique, I can simulate the sound of any instrument, and here is my interpretation of the wooden instrument. Is it wooden? The wooden instrument known as the violin. I don't know, it's maybe somebody made of metal violin. The string instrument known as the violin is my impression. See, I was playing leather pants on the violin with my mouth. How talented am I? How friggin' talented? Is this not the only video game live stream you've ever heard where the streamer does a perfect impression of somebody playing a minor internet song on a fake violin with their mouth. You've never heard that. You've never heard that. Listen, the world's a cruel and unforgiving place.
I'd
go with that. I mean, I was abused as a child and ended up killing my father, and then spent the rest of my life, or at least the rest of my adolescence, trying to punish the Pharaoh for it. So yeah, I'll take that. That's pretty accurate. But you've gotten by so far. That's also true. Prototype Siren says, "You are the most talented individual I've ever had the pleasure of watching." Emphasis on the pleasure. Also the watching, because that's what you're doing. So why? 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 When you're as talented, as attractive as I am, the world is your plaything. How did they get my yearbook quote in this? How did they find that? Oh, this, look at this Batman. This is me and Bacora. This is the exact difference between me and Bacora. If you ever wanted, in writing, the difference between our two personalities and lives, this, our philosophies, you might say, our macabre philosophies. There is, when you're as talented as, listen, when you're as talented as and attractive as I am, the world is your plaything. I like to play with the world. JBoy44 Dragon Ball fan, what is all that fruit you just dropped in my chat? Who told you you could just drop all that fruit there? And then Bacora, here's my impression. Listen, here's my impression of Bacora. Bye, Rom the Noodle. Here's my impression. 2. Because I keep it a secret. You have no idea the bloody truths I've learned, you bloody idiot, Bacora. Marik, I mean, one of those. Anthony Lara Jr., I noticed you. You're welcome. Blade7 wants to buy me a taco. Oh, I'm like, let's choose a different kind of character so we stand out from the other game. And then it's the same friggin' guy. I'm a lady now, though. Doc Indigo says, is this Marik or Malik? I always pronounce it wrong. It's none of them. It's Malik. It's Malik. You have been embraced by the Toreador clan. The Toreador. Toreador. Known as artists, visionaries, yes, thank you, and members of high society. Well, I like to blaze it on occasion. Toreadors have great connection with the mortal world through arts and entertainment. We buy lots of porn, is what they're saying. Masters of communication and social skills. That's me, bitch! Toreadors fit right in with the mortals who adore them. Speaking of mortals who adore me, hi, chat. Here we go. Your vampire's attributes and abilities have now been determined and entered into its character sheet. Yes. These are your attributes and abilities which feats are derived from. I know how the game works. Shut the frig up. I'm skipping all this. Yes. Thank you, pop-ups. Oh, I'm a sexy lady. Is it on or off? I never can tell. I'm gonna assume it's on. Malike! I am Malachite! Here we go. So we got, strength is okay, dexterity is okay, stamina is okay, it's pretty average. But then I can manipulate the hell out of you, and I can look damn good in a tutu. That's not my line. My wits are pretty good. Yeah, I'm pretty witty. Why is my intelligence just a 1? That's insulting. This game is insulting. And I perceive the hell out of things. It knows not of me. Brawl, dodge! That's Dragon Ball Z abridged, that's not me. Kenma Kozome says, I fucking love you. Well, thank you. I don't know how else to respond to that. A simple Time Lord says, Marik, do you have what it takes to become Egypt's? Do you have what it becomes to take? Do you have what it takes to become Egypt's next top model? I am already Egypt's top model, so I predated your question. So there. Noah DeNinja says, this chat is firing up as much as Yugi's mixtape. In that I set it on fire. Yeah! Okay. The embrace. The act of being hugged by a guy who is very nice. Oh. Holy frig.
They have done the sexy times. No, the handcuffs. Why are they down there? Did we handcuff a leprechaun? Oh. I am the wittiest of the tittiest. Heartbeat, why do you miss when I've had a vampire suck out my blood? It's been like 3 hours. That is some post-coitus. Pills over here. Zaphod? What a two-faced name for a clock company. I'm a lady. I'm a sexy lady. That's exciting. See things from a different perspective. A sexy perspective. A persextive. It's me, it's my other character. Oh, frig. Tarzan just murdered you. And so did the Merovingian. So do Kaiba-sama.
My fellow
So slowly sweeps the stake away from my chest.
The prior engagements you may have had this evening.
Yeah. I had bridge club, but okay.
It's a troubling one.
Yeah.
We are here because the laws that bind our society, the laws that
I need to go to the bathroom,
have been broken. As prince, I am within my rights to grant.
She's wearing more than I usually do.
The privilege of siring. Many of you have come to me seeking.
Just had a check on my wrist right there.
Endorsed some of these requests. However, the accused that sits before you tonight was not refused permission. Indeed.
Check out the Arashok back there.
Assault at all.
All glory to the Kuhn! That's the Kuhn from Dragon Age.
It pains me to announce the sentence, as up to tonight I considered the accused a loyal and upstanding member of our organization.
He's not upstanding right now, is he? It's jokes. Jokes right there.
The penalty for this transgression is death. Know that I am no more adjudicator than I am a servant.
Evil Chris Evans is right.
Let tonight's proceedings serve as a reminder to our community.
Hail Hydra.
That we must adhere to the code that binds our society, lest we endanger all of our blood.
Ta-da!
Forgive me.
Okay. I'll forgive you for leaning down like that, you strange fellow. Gross. And they're vampires. They've seen some gross stuff.
The ill-begotten progeny. Without a sire,
I'm not a progeny. My nipples are fine. Thank you. Thank you for asking.
The laws they must obey. Therefore, I have decided that
this is bullshit.
I've decided that too. He said a bad word. Everybody leave. Grr. Gobble, 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 gobble. Archfiend God, I will say your name when I'm good and ready.
They shall be instructed in the ways of our kind and be granted the same rights.
I guess.
Let no one say I am unsympathetic to the plights and causes of this community. I thank you all for attending these proceedings.
Vampire lives matter.
Their significance is not lost.
Yugi is not better, are you kidding me? That guy, he knows nothing. Check out the carpets, they're beautiful. We had them installed. Why are they showing me the carpet? Oh, did the game crash? That would suck. Speaking of sucking. Oh no. Reload, maybe? Okay, let's try that again, guys. I knew something would go wrong when I try and do things. Okay. Restarting the game. Oh, what the? No, this is not the same game, guys. Are you friggin' kidding me? No! It's okay, we can get through that very quickly. Sorry about that. That was unfortunate. Glitches, you know. Character sheet. Toreador female. And then it was, manipulation appearance. And then wits. I remember being very witty. Then brawl, dodge. I think that's it. Try again. Sorry, guys. Am I not? Do I still have points left? Okay, 4. Okay, blah, blah, blah. How does this not work? Oh, I see. Okay, try again. Russian lovemaking. Is that what this is? Are they in Russia? In Russia, vampires sucks you. No. In Soviet Russia, vampires sucked by you. That doesn't make sense. All right, can we not skip this nonsense? There's no way to skip this. Well, that's friggin' annoying. In the meantime, let's talk about something. Let's talk about the fact that next year, there is a new Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie coming out to America. Did you guys know about that? I should stream more often, says Bam Bam Boyles. Hey, maybe I'll stream with a game that chooses to friggin' work from time to time. That would be fun. Listen, there's a new Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie coming out next year. I don't know if you didn't know about it. It's called Vampire... No, it's called Yu-Gi-Oh! I saw a vampire come in and I thought I should say vampire. It's called Yu-Gi-Oh! The Dark Side of Dimensions. And I have a bit of a bone to pick with those guys for making a movie named after the very luxurious tone of my skin, the Dark Side of Dimensions. That's the name of my, that's the exact name of my beautiful skin color. And listen, I was originally going to be in that movie. I was going to be, there was going to be an extended opening sequence where people, the people looking for Yugi, they're looking for the puzzle, because it's been lost. And, listen, I, the guy's talking over me, it's confusing and distracting. The original storyline was, the archaeologists that were looking for the puzzle were going to come to me and say, listen, Marik, we know you are a bountiful, you are a spring of knowledge, you are the most learned person in all of Egypt. You know everything. You know everything about the pharaoh and the puzzle and everything. So we thought we'd come to you, since you're guarding the tomb of the pharaoh and everything. And so I, and it cuts to me, and I'm sitting there, and I'm drinking wine, and I have servant girls waiting on me hand and foot, and I'm practically naked. You can see everything if you use your imagination.
Forgive me.
Forgive you for what? Talking over me the whole time? Yes, fine. They cut me out of the movie, Zero. Originally, it was going to be just a 10-20-minute scene of me being doted upon by beautiful men and women, while these archaeologists come in and they're like, where's the puzzle, Marik? And I'm like, give me a second, I'm busy. Give me a second here, guys. Therefore, and so they would stand off to one side while I eat grapes fed to me by a young lady or a young man, one or the other. And then I would get undressed and I would go to the shower and I would take a very steamy shower with water dripping down my naked follicles. And friggin', and then they would be like, Marik, we're in a bit of a hurry. We want to know where the puzzle is so that we can get this movie started. And I'm like, hang on. I have to scrub. And then I start scrubbing every inch of my nakedness. And then friggin', why does this keep happening? It keeps crashing on me. It keeps showing an invisible person with no carpet. With a carpet, with no person. This is surreal. What if this is the game, guys? What if this is the game? Carpet Simulator 2017. Oh, wait. Things are happening. I quit too soon, I think. Nope.
Sire, tragic. My apologies. But you see,
okay, so yeah, what the frig was that? I thought it had crashed, but it just was showing me the carpet. Holy frig! Holy frig, is that for real? Is that part of the game? After seeing somebody get brutally murdered after I made love to them and was sired, they friggin' cut to the carpet for a good 5 minutes? What? What? I'm so confused, especially now, given that there's no more carpets in this location, why they felt the need to focus on the friggin' carpet.
There, you will meet an agent by the name
that door behind him is enormous. He's like significantly smaller than that door.
I've shown you.
Look at that emergency exit. Is that door for like a giant person?
Don't come back.
Is he a hobbit vampire? Friggin' daft. Cupcake CAJ says, Marik, do you watch Vampire Nights? Is that like Baywatch Nights, only with vampires? Use the mouse to look around. Okay. Ba-ba-ba, I am doing the thing that you told me to do, Mr. Video Game. Look at the graffiti, it says, Ash? Ash? I can't friggin' read it. Where are we? It's John DiMaggio, Vampire. He's gonna talk to me.
What a scene.
Speaking of scenes, I'm gonna go back and talk about that friggin' Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie coming out, The Dark Side of Dimensions. The archaeologists, they were gonna come in and be like, Marik, we need to find the puzzle, and you are the person who knows the most about ancient Egypt and the Pharaoh in particular. Where is it? Where's the puzzle? And it was gonna cut to me, and it's gonna do a slow pan up my body, from my feet, up my body, to my face. Okay. And then it was gonna slowly zoom in my face, and I would be like, hang on a second, I need to dry off. This is 15 minutes into the film now, and they haven't learned anything from me, just that I have a great bottom. I'm just gonna slowly zoom in on me while I towel off. I get my hair nice and dry. I put on a facial mask. And then, like, slowly, I start just trimming my nails. I just take as much time as possible to really make sure my body is as clean and as well-groomed as I can. Meanwhile, these archaeologists are standing in the doorway being like, excuse me, can you tell us more about the puzzle? Because we really need to get the movie going. And then I was going to be like, hang on. And then I would sit down in the chair and turn the television on and start watching cartoons. And I would laugh and say, this is a particularly funny episode of SpongeBob. And then the archaeologists were going to say, Marik, we've waited a long time. We've come hundreds of miles to learn about this ancient secret that is hidden within the sand dunes of Egypt. The wild landscape of the desert that is your home. And we need the secret, we need to know. We need to know about the grand pharaoh and his life. And I was gonna say, look, let me at least program my TiVo box to record this episode of SpongeBob. And then I'll be right, this is 20 minutes into the film. 20 minutes into the film. It was originally gonna be a 2-hour movie and they had to cut it down to 90 minutes. And unfortunately, I was the part that got cut. So when you do eventually see Yu-Gi-Oh! The Dark Side of Dimensions in theaters, which obviously you will. I mean, that's like the Avengers of the 2017 period. Obviously you will. Make a mental note. Make a note to yourself that this was originally a much longer, much meatier film with a much better story arc because they removed my scene. My long 20, 30 minute scene might have been 45 minutes. Ivan Bragnowski says, can you give my friend Rochelle a shout out? Rochelle! Rochelle! I shouted you out. There you go. Righteous. It was going to be a much better film, is what I'm saying. It was going to be much more entertaining. I'm just saying. Wouldn't you have enjoyed that? Wouldn't you have enjoyed that much more? Maybe they'll release the director's cut. John DiMaggio, you entertain me no more. Oh, gosh. Gosh, we're going to the city already. I thought we were playing the tutorial. Ah, frig. Okay. I slipped into lots of things. Okay. My sink! Pizza? Vampires can't eat pizza. What self-respecting vampire orders a pizza anyway? That is the most immaculately presented pizza I've ever seen, I have to say. Wait a second. One bed. There's clearly only one person lives here. Why are there two pizzas? Completely untouched. Is this part of my attempt to blend in with the living? Every so often I'll order a pizza. and then nobody will suspect that I'm a vampire. I like to pretend that that's my excuse for ordering multiple pizzas in real life as well. Don't want to have people think I'm a vampire, so I'd better order lots of pizzas. And since I have these pizzas, I'd better eat them. Lacuna Coil. Whatever that is. What do we got? Boo. Disgusting. At your convenience, please come and visit me in my home downtown. I leave you this to guide me. A silly poem that makes no sense. Can you just give me directions? Like, turn right at the broken lamp. I'm sure that'll narrow it down, too. Turn right at the broken lamp. What is this? Shampoo and conditioner? Take two bottles into the shower? Not me. I just suck someone's body dry of all their vital blood and organs and go. What do we got? Email. Beep, beep. What do we got? Remember when you had to physically type into a computer in a game? Artemis Silver says, where do you obtain bootyliciousness such as yours? At the booty shop, obviously. What is wrong with you? Password, what? I have to hack my own laptop? Triangulating the signal. What? What? I friggin' forget how I do this. Hey, the... Thank you. The password for your computer is sunrise. I'm changing it to giantbots123. Okay, so email. Sunrise. Dang, it's big, you know. That's one of the emails I got. Thank you. Subject, dang, it's big, you know, from Hunglo. Whoa! I have no need for this. I am not writing this number down in case I need it later. No. Looking for that lazy-ass husband who's late on his alimony payments. Aren't we all? I certainly am. His name starts with a B. Boop, oop a doop. How about that jerk who knocked you up? Look no further. With Arthur Kilpatrick's amazing crime pewter. I want one of those. I could give or take Arthur Kilpatrick, but I need an amazing crime pewter that I have to hack into. You can find almost anyone with a record, and these days, that's just about everyone. Actually, these days, most people listen to MP3s, but this is a dated game, so... Wait, did it mean crime record? Oh, I feel silly. Hi, Major Motoko. She's fangirl squeeing. Everyone has a moment in their life when they have to fangirl squee. I fangirl squeed when I saw the trailer for the new Jason Bourne movie. There was a lot of squeeing. A lot of squee leakage happened. So come on down to Arthur Kilpatrick's bail bonds. I mean, that's kind of funny. Hey, welcome to town. Hey, welcome to town. Come on over to my place once you get situated. I'll talk about what you need to get the job done. I'm going to pick up explosives right now. Some astrolite. That's familiar. I should be back by the time you come over. I'm at 24 Main Street in number 4. Walk to the end of the alley. See, this is directions. This is actual concrete information that you can actually use to decipher a place to go. Anyway, the opening. The opening from a friend. The game begins. A pawn is moved. And I am sad. It's a bad haiku. Quit. Quit the game. No. In case you hadn't realized, I'm playing with the high definition patch, which makes the game look significantly better, so you can actually read the text on wall textures and stuff like that. It's exciting. Wait, there was something in here, wasn't there? I already picked it up. Okay. Marik can only be a 10 out of 10 if he's gay, because all 10 out of 10... What are you on about, Jake Idoney? I should not look at the chat. It's confusing and distracting. But I must. Yet I cannot. But I must. Here we go. Something in here. Money envelope. The best kind of envelope. I already gave Rochelle a shout out, Ivan Brigansky. Don't be a shout hog. 507. Don't need that. Well, Mr. Dude Nater said, where the magic question, which is, where is Bakora? That's a bit of a touchy subject, I won't lie. And I don't mean in the sense that I like to touch him. Because even if I did like to touch him,
You got some change, lady?
Apparently, the actor for this guy mistook being drunk for sounding like some sort of deformed alien organism. I sound like Lur from the planet Omicron Persei, whatever it was. I'm not giving this guy money.
Bitch.
What? Bum says bitch. How friggin' dare you? He sounds completely different now. What the frig? Listen, that was uncalled for. Watch your tongue, mister. Bacora and I were on a break of sorts in that he broke my heart. And I'm sure he feels like something is broken. I don't know. He broke wind plenty of times, I'll tell you that much. He's stinky. But listen. He's gone. He might come back. I have plans to, I don't know if seduction is the right term, but I will lure him back with my wiles, my evil wiles. The trash. Hey, it's Bacora. Oh. Hello, lady.
Hey, honey.
Why is she already a vampire? That's upsetting. Kenma Kazume says, we still love you. Well, thank you so much. This guy has a cool jacket. I want his jacket. He's giving me that side eye. He's like, hey, man. Well, actually, I'm a lady. He's probably looking at me and thinking, hey, what's up? Millennium Rod FTW, indeed. Palm trees. It's like being back home, except significantly more polluted. Remember when you could see the sky? No wonder vampires like it here. What's up? Christian Bale?
Yes, is there something I can help you with?
Loki Mama Bear says, hey, Marik, can I get a shout out for my girlfriend, Diana? I want to show her this when she's not busy studying for college to help to cheer her up. Loki Mama Bear, I'd be happy to say that. Diana, hang in there. College is difficult. And I should know, because I didn't go. I lived underground and was withheld from society. But college is tough. But remember that what is tough now, when you look back at it in 5 or 10 years, it'll be just a memory. And it won't be tough to look back on it, but you'll feel very proud of yourself that you got through it. Just like I feel pride when I will destroy the Pharaoh and evil will reign, haha, and such.
Waiting for that blasted tow truck. Yeah.
Guy sounds like my Valentine.
This part of town, this time of night, rather dreadful place, don't you think?
Oh, Richard Hawkins, you're right. I can't go in the nightclub unless I talk over the music. I could be in trouble. Could I persuade you to help me out? My wallet's been stolen. I don't even know this guy, but I would like his money.
Afraid I'm a little short on cash right now. I'm so sorry.
I don't know if I like this guy or the bum more, really.
I'm happily married to my work, and I have a wife, too.
Well, good for you.
The taxpayers are certainly not getting their money's worth here.
What are you talking about? This guy's just here to be the professional 1%. He's just here to look down on everything. DJ Quinn says, hey, Marik, is Pecora's birthmark on the left or the right buttock? I know you know. How do you know it's not on both? Here we go. How do you know his butt isn't just a conglomeration of birthmarks? Man, somebody else ordered pizza. Oh! How do you lose this much blood? And also, how does it get significantly more... How does the volume increase? Surely, like, the more you bleed, the less you have. But this guy was like, I have a small cut. Check this out. How will you see this? Getting through the loading screen. Look, one, a bad thing obviously happened here. Probably involving this guy, because he looks shifty. He's walking off the street. I know you did it. I know it was you. I know it was you. Stop what you're doing, because I know it was you. Oh, wait. What? There's more. What? It happened here. Okay, wait. Follow the trail. I never even knew there was a trail. It happened in the car. The car is the murderer! Even though nobody has definitively died yet, the car is responsible. It's friggin' Christine. Anyway, yes. It started here. I don't know what happened. The car stabbed a man. The car stabbed somebody. He comes this way. Less blood. Okay, so he's managed to make it from here. He started here. He was like, ow! A car stabbed me. And it did a bad job of parking as well. Look at this! Look at this! This is the real crime! This is the real crime, you jackass car! You psychotic, murderous... What are you? What kind of vehicle are you? 101 PCE. More like 101 pretty creepy elephant. What? What a... Look at this nonsense. But yeah, he got stabbed by the car. Shanked him right in the side. It was like... Stink. Ow. And then he bled. He bled a lot right here. He walked over here with no blood coming out of him. He walked over here, got here, and then a little bit more blood came out. Right here. A little bit more. Or maybe he got stabbed by multiple cars. Maybe this is actually just a witness car. Denise Lobb says, Marik, notice me. I'll change my name to Steve and help with Bacora, pretty creepy elephant. Look. For all I know, you're in league with the creepy elephants, okay? Stabbed here. This guy was stabbed right here. Nothing. No blood. Bleeding again. One more time. He bled a little bit. He was like, he held it in pretty well. Maybe he had like a I'm analyzing the frig out of this. He got a little bit of blood spurted out. He was like, it's okay. I'm good. I don't need help. In front of all these people, he was bleeding this much. He goes this way. Bleeds again, a much more scattered amount of blood this time. Police officer didn't see anything. Bum didn't see anything. Are you arresting this bum for calling me a bitch? Please do. Oh no. Taking him to the pretty creepy... He's taking him to where the pretty creepy elephant committed murder or something. The police are in on it. The police, they're crooked. Pretty crooked elephants, more like. Listen to me. Hey, I'm talking to you. My tax dollars pay your salary. Don't yawn at me when I'm trying to lecture you. He's got a great ass, though. Look at that. Look at those hips. Look at the way he's moving those hips. That's impressive. Are you going to hang out with these bums? Is this your life? Your life? I feel bad for you, sir. You ignored the pretty creepy elephant crime scene. And then went and hung out with some bums. Da-da-da-da-da-da. There's the blood. Starts there. Stabbed by a car. Spurted out a little bit. Kept walking. Nobody noticed. Spurted out a lot more. It was gusher. It was like... Right there. Kept going. Spurted out a lot more right here. I don't know how he did that. Because from what it looked like before, he was crawling. But he managed to not get any blood until he got here. Maybe he jumped. Maybe he... Let's see if we can do it. Hey! No, can't quite make it, so he's a phenomenal jumper. Or he was just able to withhold all that blood. Then he gets in here. This is what I'm trying to tell you right here. He gets in here. Suddenly, a little bit of blood. He got through the front door and was like, oh, and lost a little bit more blood. Then he gets here. Blood, 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 blood. Blood! What the frig? My skills are useless. How did he start bleeding even more when he got here? Does that make sense? Does that make any logical sense? That his blood got worse the more he moved. Jet Lane, I will not go in your room, my skills. Stop! Freaking. Ah! Hello. Explain this blood phenomenon to me, you high jumping victim of the pretty creepy elephants.
Those mothers ripped me off. I'm dying here.
Obviously, but tell me about how you were able to keep your blood in for that long.
What is this lump? Is this my rib?
That's your penis.
Shit, my rib is poking through my side?
That's a penis.
I'm all numb.
You don't understand basic biology, physiology. He doesn't know what a penis is.
I'm lying here bleeding to death and you're cracking wise?
Look, it's what I do. I'm streaming video games, okay?
Goddamn chemist.
Who says chemist? Are you from the 15th century? Or Europe?
Guy mixes up speed, his crew sells it.
Moira Collinsworth, don't kink shame us.
I show up at the beach with the money, right? Four of these
kink pride.
Nowhere. Junkie bricks.
Oh, that's unnecessary.
It feels like I got a friggin' horse kicking it. Those cocksuckers.
Jeez. Come on, man.
I had to crawl to my car, call my ass up.
This is offensive.
The vamp blood's the only thing holding me together. But shit.
This guy, he makes Quentin Tarantino look like an episode of Charlie Brown.
You can't tell anybody. Nobody can know I blew it. Promise me. If they find out I'm a dead man. With you types, I screw up once and it's over. You hear me? I'm a goddamn memory.
What? I will never be a memory in the words of Squall Leonhart. Squall Leonhart? What the frig is his name?
Listen, I got connections. I'll set you up. But, oh, son of a bitch. My leg's gone numb. Damn it. You got me by the balls here. Whatever
I don't want to touch any part of your body at this point. It's covered in blood.
Those small-time sons of bitches live out in a dump on the beach. Four or five of them. And one's got the explosives is Dennis.
Good to know.
Money too, that prick.
Now that's a thug name if I've ever heard one. Dennis. Is he a menace?
Laying in a pool in my own blood and you want friggin' directions.
Ah, thank you.
All right. Down the street, in the parking garage, stairs down to the beach, on the right. Those better not be some of my last words.
I mean, as last words go, it's no kiss me hardy or whatever, but it's okay. At least you weren't swearing this time.
You gotta get it back from him. Maybe reason with him, maybe break in.
For
know.
Some reason, being him. A vampire has caused me to become severely injured.
Do what I know.
Thank you, Bront, for the heads up on that. I'll go get the Astrolite. And you try not to like leave huge swaths of... What the frig did you do here? How did you just like smush your entire lower half of your body where your ribs are sticking out on the light switch? Your hands don't seem... Your hands are fine. Your hands are just peachy. How did you do this? Did you just open up your chest wound and, like, just smear it all over this? This makes no sense. You haven't even tried calling anybody, because I would know if you had, because the phone would be drenched in blood and guts and entrails, because you apparently can't keep yourself from smudging everything with your bloody blood. You bloody fool. Thank you, Hiroko-san Mazaki. There we go. See, this makes sense. If he were to get hurt here, and there's blood everywhere, and then it starts to slow down, if he had walked outside, maybe that's what happened. I just realized I analyzed the crime scene all wrong. What happened was, somebody came in here, stabbed the crap out of him, and then, after they finished stabbing him, apparently a million times, judging by the amount of blood involved, after they'd finished doing that, he fell down. Did he die? Oh, he's okay. After they finished stabbing him, they went over to the light switch. No, he went over to the light switch and was like, splat. Oh, my wound. Here's a reenactment of the crime scene. Ow, 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 I'm being stabbed. Ow, 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 ow. Multiple ows. Sploosh, sploosh, sploosh. There goes my blood. Oh, I'd better switch off the light before I leave. Smush. Smush my blood on the light switch. And then also on this door. And then he slowly made his way out, trying to find some help. And of course the blood was less as he kept walking. and then he left the friggin' apartment complex. Splooshed all over there. That's the official sound effect for bleeding. It's sploosh. He looked around. He noticed that the police weren't going to do jack because they like to pretend they don't see anybody. They're just like, la la la, I'm not listening, crime doesn't exist, blah blah blah. Yes, see, good job, man. Good, great job keeping eyes on situation. This guy leaves the apartment complex, stands here. What is this guy doing? What the? Oh, you're just looking out, okay. Now that's creepy, that's suspicious behavior. Are you a pretty creepy elephant, sir? Have you ever been an endangered species? Have you ever had your tusks hunted for whatever people hunt elephant tusks for? I think some people use it as an erogenous object. I don't know. Have people ever used your tusks as an erogenous object, sir? All right. Stood here, splooshed all over the floor, and then looked over here, saw there was a friggin' hospital, and then was like, nah, and then went this way, bled a little bit more, and then walked this way, and then looked at, what the? Holy frig. That blood isn't even on the floor. That blood is levitating. That blood is officially performing a miracle. This goes beyond anything I expected to see. This is... I thought this was some conspiracy where cars were methodically stabbing people and parking very poorly in the guise of some pretty creepy elephants. But instead, they have performed a miracle and caused the blood to levitate. I don't even know what that means. I don't even know what that means. What the frig? This town is insane. This lamp is a hexagon, an octagon? That's an octagon. I know my shapes. Hey guys, you'll never believe what I discovered today. They are not happy with me. I have never felt more uncomfortable stares than I'm getting from these guys. Hi, how's it going? You mind if I hog all the warmth from this thing? This unnaturally occurring flame you have in this barrel? This barrel that looks like it was blown up by the Doom guy already? So anyway, guys, a car totally stabbed a guy and his blood is levitating right over there. What? Oh, there's another guy. Okay, look, you can have this barrel if you want it. Okay, we can all hang out now. We're all friends. Whoa, where'd he get that? Man, he is poor in everything but spirit. And alcoholism. So yeah, we're hanging out with the hobo guys. The hobo bros. Hey, do you guys mind if I call you my hobo bros? Is that offensive? Is hobo an offensive slur for you guys? Is it offensive to the hobo culture? Don't look, guys. It's that police officer. Oh, we're not committing any crimes. I'm not investigating the pretty creepy elephants. Okay, good. He's gone. Listen. You guys, if we can capture some of this levitating blood on camera, or even just take some... What are you doing? Stop drinking! Fred! You have a problem. I'm willing to help you, but first you have to help... What is... Oh, he's just breathing on the... Yes. First you have to help me, because we have to take some of this blood to the hospital and show them this amazing secret that we've learned, that we found. Look at this frigging... Guys! Guys, the fire isn't that important. I know, you're homeless. It sucks. But we can do something. This is our chance to make a stand and prove that we're not just a bunch of guys who stand around in the same exact outfit. And this guy isn't just an alcoholic. What are you doing? Stop! Stop drinking! You don't even have any booze in there. You're just pretending over and over. Fred, you have a problem. And Ed, and you just stare transfixed at Fred all the time. And this guy sounds like he's 99 years old. Hobo bros, assemble! What the? Watch their scarves. Look, you see that? When I turn away from them, their scarves start to float. What's this? What is? Are they mocking me with their scarves? Okay, I see how it is. Oh, la-di-da, look at me. I don't have a home or a job. And I just hang around a barrel all day, fanning my hands over the flames. Oh, and then some attractive, sexy man, or woman in this case, shows up and tells me about this crazy thing about this blood over here that is levitating and is not touching the floor. I don't know which is more impressive. The fact that the road is completely untouched by the blood? Or the fact that this car... The police officers walked back past this like 5 times now. And nobody's put a ticket on this friggin' thing. Nocturnal X says, Manic, have you ever tattooed your buttocks? No, but people have tattooed my buttocks on their bodies many times. Because really, what is more beautiful than the image of my buttocks? Nothing. Certainly not this jackass. Try and deny me. I defy you to deny the truth. What? Jaywalking? I'm standing perfectly still on the street. What the? He doesn't even understand what jaywalking is. Jared Van Orden. If I am your password for everything, that means that I have access to all your personal information, which I don't. So I would suggest changing your password. Check it out, guys. The windows are so steamy, there must be some lovemaking going on in there. Wait a minute. The cars, they could stab me at any moment. I had best flee. DJ Quinn says, are you going to kill another prostitute this time? I have no plans. But let's see where this night takes us. Hey, what's going on? What's going on, guys? Oh, hey, Gothy McGotherson. Ah, the asylum. On 2nd Street in Santa Monica, October 31st, featuring Die My Darling and The Empire Hideouts, also known as basically the same band, judging by the photo. This guy... He posed right next to it. It was perfect. Stand here. Hey, dude. I want to stand right next to the poster so you look like a walking cliche. Yes! There it is. Let me in. God friggin' yeah! I worship you. I pray at the altar that is the boxes of the foxes. I have found you. You are here. Look at this lady. What is she doing sitting on the bee? There are so many other... There are much sexier letters than B, such as M. Why don't you sit on an M? M for Marik. What is this? How do I get in? I can't enter the foxy boxes. I can't discover what is inside the temple of the foxed boxed. But that's silly. The foxy boxes are the remix. The revival of the foxes, the boxes of the foxes. A smoke shop? Hell yeah! Where is it? I wanna vape. I wanna vape some stuff. I wanna get totally smoked, y'all. Do I sound cool and hip yet? The corner thief says, hey, Marik, I'm having a really bad day, and I'm really not myself, and I wanted to ask you, if you don't mind, can you give me a shout out? If you don't mind, thanks. Listen, chat, if you, much like Bakora Thief, are not having a good time, I want to say, there are times when I'm not having a good time. There are lots of times where I'm not having a good time. But the important thing to remember is that, like they say in Animal Crossing, bad times are just bad times that are just times that are bad. And it's temporary. No matter how bad things seem right now, you will get through it. and you will find a place and a time in your life where you're you are meant to be and where you feel happiest. And hey, maybe that's temporary too. You can look at it that way. But it's still going to happen. You're still going to get there. And honestly, it's worth the trouble. It's worth the struggle. It's worth the pain, and it's worth the sadness. You'll be okay. You'll be fine. Because, you know, there are people who've been through really terrible stuff that have come out with a much more positive outlook on life. We are stronger than we know. And I'm a sexy Egyptian villain from the anime Yu-Gi-Oh! And that's what I think. Listen to this guy. This guy knows what he's talking about. This guy has a very positive outlook on life. Tell us your philosophy, sir. Tell us about how you get through bad times. Dude, that's your cue. You're not gonna... Well, that's not really what we wanted to hear right now, but okay. That was unfortunately timed. Hey, hobo guy. How's it going? Your friends weren't listening to me when I told them that a guy got stabbed by a vehicle. What do you think about that? Dean Ambrose. He looks like friggin' Dean Ambrose. This is what Dean Ambrose was doing before he became a professional wrestler. WWE champion right here. This is what would have happened if he didn't get drafted. Nom nom nom. I'm sucking on Dean Ambrose's neck. It's all good. Bad times are just times that are bad guys. That's right. Bail bonds! We're going in here.
Hello, LA.
Hi. Where is all the furniture, man? What happened? Your feng shui is way off. This can't be good for your feng... What do you call it? Your chakra? I don't know. Wait a second. Where are the butts? Where are the butt magazines? Not enough buttocks. What, there is a friggin' magazine called Hooker? I refuse to believe that there is a magazine called Hooker. Why can't... I wanted a magazine about butts. That it's a lot more innocent. Wait. Motor whore mag... What the... Bitch. I like how I gravitated towards the least offensive word on the friggin' table. Hooker? My gosh. The bitch frenzy over here. She sniffed you. Where? My goodness. These magazines have all the subtlety and grace of a Leisure Suit Larry game. What's going on, man?
Welcome to Kilpatrick 24-Hour Bail Bonds. My name's Arthur Kilpatrick. How can I help you?
Oh. Tell him I put the rice on for dinner.
Thank you. Cool. That sounds good. Sorry. My associate was telling me that the rice has been put on for dinner. So I'm going to be wrapping things up here in 20 minutes, half an hour. But I want to keep playing for now. Look at this freaking guy. He looks like Paul Heyman and Paul Bearer had a baby. A lot of wrestling references today. Lisa Holtzofa, I think that's how you say their name, says, will you please call Bacora, Marik? Okay. Bacora! I called him. He didn't come. Nothing happened. I will tell you, though, I do intend to get back together with Bacora at some point. I don't mean to spoil anything, but you might see. You might see a certain video. What is this? What is this? No, 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 no. Oh, Slender. I see. There might be a certain video series coming out called, I don't want to give away what the contents are, but there is a series of videos coming called Project Butt Touch. Hashtag Project Butt Touch. And they will feature content. If you like Bacora and Marik, you will enjoy, and you want them to get back together again, then you will enjoy what happens in those videos. You will like them. I don't want to say anything else for fear of spoiling it. But if you like that, then you'll like that.
Well, my business ain't bad, I can tell you that much. Santa Monica's gone downhill. Used to be pretty nice, I guess.
Your face has gone downhill.
Now that we did a few years ago, but we gotta
ship the yowie!
Jumpers and crap like that.
Can you just tell me what the quest is?
Goes with the business. Then you sick the
DJ Quinn says, have you seen or read My Hero Academia? I have not. I don't know what it is. Based on the title, I'm going to assume that it is some sort of crossover between Little Witch Academia and the British sitcom My Hero. Hashtag Project Backtouch. Wait, did I get a quest?
Hey there. Sure, honey, what is it?
Don't call me that. Oh, I'm a girl. I keep forgetting.
Of course. Goes with the business. Why? You betcha.
Shut up.
Yep, damn.
Shut up.
Well, great. Sure, honey, what is...
Okay, anyway, carrying on. Shut up, radio. Eh. Kilpatrick's... There it is, the crime pewter. I wanted to see this crap, man. It's not as impressive as the name, I'll tell you that much. What has he got here? Is this... What? There was pizza here, I guarantee it. Look. It's the villain of Season 4 of Yu-Gi-Oh! Darts! There it is. What a hilarious joke. Wait, donuts? Eclairs? Where is all the pizza? This guy might be a vampire. He didn't order any pizza. That is suspicious. It is 12. What's the date? Oh, he's got my favorite calendar. Random parking lots monthly. Random parking lots 2017. Beautiful. What did he get there? A certificate of... What does it say? Kid? Kid cops, I'm a strong, and licenses. Kid cops, I'm a strong, licenses. What? Sounds like some sort of movie pitch. Kid cops, I'm a strong, licenses. Don't miss this. TV. There's nothing on. There's never anything on. What we got over here? Man, the FBI, if they knew about me, I would be top of their most wanted list. But instead, I'm on the top of the wanted list for all the ladies. Pizza! He is not a vampire! So yes, I don't know anything about My Hero Academia. That is completely a foreign concept to me, I'm afraid. Okay. I'm gonna go this way. Got another 20 minutes or so, and then I'm gonna have to... Let's see if this guy has any words of wisdom.
Lead to the spinal columns of the great beast's hall. All you walk willingly to the eternal feast of the guilty.
Dude, you have no idea. I saw a car...
I have seen the face of the demon, and it is excited.
I've seen his emoji. He sent me a text. He sent me the excited emoji. Shush! Yes, yes, lots of squirming on the horizon. I'd like to squirm on his horizon. Wait, what? But, friggin' hell. What's this person doing? This isn't suspicious at all. Gillian Anderson! Special cameo. Where's Mulder? I have a friggin' X-File for you, let me tell you. There are cars stabbing people. Oh, we can leave. Oh, no, it's just a map. Okay. How are you guys doing, chat? Oh, that's lovely. Marik, would you tag team in a fuel with Bakora? He is the fuel, you fuelish fuel. I would totally tag team with him. Our tag team would be called... Thief Kings. I don't know. What's a good name? What's a good name for our tag team? Rod? The Ring and the Rod. Rod and Ring. R&R. Rest and Recreation. Rest and Relaxation. Rest and Recreation. What's happening? Okay. Let's go find the Astrolite. Man. I would love to do a stream of just wrestling Yu-Gi-Oh! Characters. I should get the new wrestling game. Or even the old wrestling game and just make a bunch of Yu-Gi-Oh! Characters and just host my own tournaments to make Battle City look like a cakewalk. What is a cakewalk anyway? Are the cakes getting up and walking away? because I'm going to eat them? Or is it just like you're walking in a cake? Because that sounds difficult. Walking in a cake?
Up there, through that chain link gate and up those stairs.
Thank you, ambiguously accented young lady.
Those men you are looking for.
Oh, yeah. How did you know I was looking for men?
Never mind. You wouldn't understand.
Are you judging me like literally everybody else in the chat is? Because that's mean. Okay, let's go find those men. Hi, half-naked man and guy with green hair and Dean Ambrose fan.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Look at how unnecessarily tall this is. They did not think about... It's not very handicap accessible, is it? It's a good thing I'm not a disabled vampire. Okay, carrying on. Ah! I'm in a combat area. PvP. Oh. Can I talk to this guy? Is that an option? I'm gonna try this. Ah, there we go. Okay. So I can say, I need to get inside. I need to buy some Astralite. It's a bit direct. Or, yeah, I've always wondered if it's true intestines unravel to be 20 feet long. I also have wondered that. But I don't know if it's a good idea to bring that up. Because I don't think he'll know.
Oh, really? You call ahead? The men expecting you? Because he didn't tell me to expect anybody.
Listen, nobody expects the Marik Inquisition.
You just made my night, asshole.
Oh. Okay, we're fighting. Ow. Oh, how did I win that fight? I guess I'm a vampire, yes. Ah, frig. Okay, here we go. Oh no, this is not going according to plan. And I didn't even have a friggin' plan, so. Ha ha ha. Oh, that was a mistake. Sorry. Ow. Ha ha ha. No, leave me alone. I'm bad at the game. Ow. Boom. Boom. Strike one. That guy's voice shouldn't really be our priority right now. Ah, this is the most unexciting vampire fight with baseball bats I've ever seen. God damn it. Let's go this way. Ow, ow, ow. Okay, guys. Come on. Never follow a vampire behind a minivan. It's a bad idea. Oh, frig. Okay. This was a huge mistake. Are you dead? Oh, I think he is now. Are these guys vampires too? Oh, frig. Run away. What did I do? I made him go all glowy. Ow. Frig, yes. I like when they ragdoll. Okay, cool. How do I pick up? I pick up my tire iron. Pick up things. Ow. I'm coming for you. All right. Okay. Here we go, guys. We're going in. The Astralite is really important. And this van is friggin' tiny. Here we go. Ah! The fence is bigger than the van. They were just hanging their beach towels out to dry. I feel bad for them. And the boxes. Somebody isn't wearing a clothes on the bottom. Ah! Frig! Who is bottomless? Who is not wearing their boxes? Is it you? Ah ha ha. He's escaping. He's attacking the door. Ow. That's right. That's what you get. You friggin' pretty creepy elephants. I got a gun. Woo! Come at me, bro. Freak! Oh! I think I missed. Okay. Here we go. Nope. Wow, I'm more powerful with my fists for some reason. Hey, guy. Can I come in? Aha. The friggin' door screwed. Ah! Boom! Bow! I think I am more powerful with my fists, honestly. Yes! Why am I not doing this the whole time? Did somebody die? Who's attacking me now? What are you guys watching? You're watching this game. Okay. Where are you? Ah! Dang! Dang! Yeah! What is... Yes, the kitchen is fascinating. Yeah. No! Watch out! That was embarrassing. I'm gonna use my fists on this guy. And my sexy bottom. Ah! Yeah! That's right. That's right! That's right! Yes! I think I did it. Let's make some coffee. Some Lindsay brand coffee. Where's that astrolite? Where did you go? I did the stuff with the things. I beat the people up. They are beated. Where are we at? There it is. Car stereo. That's not important. I know you're not supposed to take it from them when they're around because they get very upset. Where's that astrolite? If I were a highly volatile explosive, where would I be? Let's see. Surf report? I need to know how the surf's doing. Malibu. This is not even remotely important, but I want to know. 2 to 3 feet, occasional larger sets, water temperature 62. So in case this game has a mini game where you have to surf, unless maybe there's a secret surfing level where you fight surfing vampires. Maybe that's what happened. What? Come on, I don't have no hacking skills. I can't triangulate no signals. Where's their password? Hashtag Project Butt Touch. That's right. Tweet it out, people. We gotta let the word know that the butts need touching. Hashtag Project Butt Touch. If you support the ship of Marik and Bakora, you will use the hashtag Project Buck Touch Macabre. Ah! Chainlink fence has defeated me once again. It's embarrassing. What is this? Huh. Oh. Oh, so if I wanted the stealthy approach, that could have worked. But who does that? Who does that? Get off me! My skills! Okay, there's stuff in here. Would you... I'm so offended by this friggin' door, you have no idea. Hashtag. There it is. Hashtag Project Astrolite. Touch. Oh, what were they doing with this? They were gonna... build some sort of denatured alcohol. Is alcohol usually natured? But they denatured it. Friggin' doors, my skills! Hey, the cars have been here. Hey, they turned the TV off. I turned the TV off with my skills. Nah. Okay, I'm gonna go for another 10 minutes or so, and then I'm gonna call it a day on streaming. But if you liked the stream, if you had a good time, and I really hope you did, I hope you enjoyed what I've done, or what I tried to do. There's the pier again. You can go over there. Vampires are the least of your problems. You will get your blood sucked by the friggin' carnival rides. I don't know what's happening. You start to say words that sound like a joke and then you forget to actually do a joke. That's my problem. But I hope you've been remotely entertained by this. Like I said, this is not going to supersede the Marik Plays Bloodlines that I was doing with Bakora. Cupcake CAJ says, Marik, do you read fanfics? And everything see fan art of you and Bakora. I have seen fan art of me and Bakora. It's all pretty accurate. Except, there's a lot more touching of butts. Not enough pictures of butt touching. Lots of butts and lots of touching, but not enough butt touching. I feel like there's a giant hole where there should be a picture of a butt being touched. But I hope you did enjoy this. I know it was spontaneous and silly, and it only really happened because I didn't have footage for a Let's Play that I wanted to do, because it corrupted on me. But you will see more Marik Plays in the future, and you will see more Marik Plays Bloodlines in the future that is actually canonical to the Marik Plays Let's Play. of Bloodlines, but this was just a fun stream that I thought I'd do. And if you didn't like it, then I'm sorry. But if you did like it, then I think we accomplished something together. I think we are fighting back against the oppression of the pretty evil, pretty cute elephants. He's dead! Oh, lame.
Yeah? Did you waste those sons of bitches?
I did, and I also turned their TV off. They were wasting electricity.
Good. Great. Hope it was painful.
Very.
Get my money back.
Oh, you mean for them? Yes, yes, that too.
Damn. I could have used that money to buy myself some new kidneys. Anyway.
That's your problem. What's wrong with your old kidneys?
You need to make someplace disappear.
What am I, David Copperfield?
To be a Sabbat interest.
Like the Copperfield of a bot.
You haven't been doing this too long, have you? The Sabbat, as I
the Sabbat.
It, your typical power-hungry
with
movie
emphasis on the bot. I like bots, have you noticed?
I tangle what they're like, let me tell you.
Ah.
I didn't enjoy it.
What? Oh. Tell me.
I heard a lot about that operation. Well, I'd love to get in there.
Amanda Martinez, just so you know, this stream that I just did will be recorded and left on the YouTube channel. So you'll be able to watch it back. I don't know if that's a good thing. Depends on your point of view. Some of it was very fun. We learned a lot about me and elephants and macabre things. And Project Butt Touch. Please, hashtag.
Tongue's laying low because of Therese. Therese Vorman, you know her?
Yeah, yeah, she and I go way back.
Therese and Tongue are feuding. I don't know the details. Mike takes that Tongue thinks he's about to get whacked, so he's gone underground till Therese calls.
Who said we're whack?
Put that warehouse into orbit anytime soon. You're gonna have to get Therese to call off the feud.
That's right, people are tweeting Project Butt Touch at me. I appreciate it. Carry on.
She and her sister Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place. I try not to do business there.
Anyway. I think I might actually call it a day on the stream. I'm losing steam while playing on Steam. Ah! Puns! One. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest number since the number one. Ha-cha! Ha-choo-choo-choo-cha! So, if you enjoyed the stream, feel free to leave a comment saying, stream was pretty fun, thanks, man. But if you didn't enjoy the stream, leave a comment that says, I'm a smelly butt and have a butt for a face. And I will take your criticism into consideration. Where are you going, hobo guy? Dude, you could be so much more. Look at this guy over here. He's no different from you. Okay, he's very different from you. Never mind. Alright. Well, standing outside Trips' pawn shop. I think I'm going to call it a day there. Thank you for watching. Please, remember to keep touching the butts. And hopefully I'll see you soon with new actual content that you'll enjoy. I'm sorry this was probably a huge letdown for everybody watching, but having said that, at least I tried. And if I tried and failed, then at least I looked sexy while doing it, right? And if you don't have that, what do you have? Butts. That's what you have. Well, I'll see you next time. Same butt time, same butt channel. I have no intention of doing it at the same time or the same butt channel, but... but I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed what little there was here to enjoy. We had some fun. We learned some things. We touched some butts. And we made some memories. Any last words for the viewers, Yugi?
Yes, I wanted to say that this was the worst stream I've ever seen, Marik. Unlike the ones that I do on my channel.
Oh yeah, what's your friggin' channel? I am the friggin' king of YouTube, and I have a sexy body, and I tell people what to do, and all my friends are nice to me. Is that your YouTube channel, Yugi?
Yes, actually, that's the exact name of my YouTube channel. Have you seen it?
Yes, I'm a subscriber.
Thanks, Marik. I appreciate the sub.
God, he's just so nice and talented. I hate him so much.
Thank you.
I gotta just wrap things up there. Hashtag Project Butt Touch, guys. Hashtag it. Et cetera. Oh, frig. 1 second. Bye-bye.